Welcome, mates. I am Bloodthirsty Lord by Yunkoi Lordy, and today we're back on Predator Hundergrounds with a very late upload due to the fact that there is a new update in Predator Hundergrounds. We'll talk about the patch notes and the actual update itself and what's contained in it. Hint, there's a new Predator character, the Cleopatra Predator, and we'll talk about everything else that is contained in this update. Should be a fun one. But before we do get to this video, there's only a small percentage of mates that watch the video that are actually subscribed. Leave a like, show your support, click the subscribe button to keep up to date, press that join button to become a member of the channel. So without further ado, let's get straight into this. So let's start off with the patch notes for this update. The new playable Predator is the Cleopatra Predator. Early access to new Predator weapon skin, the Ancient Disc. So they did a reskin of the Smart Disc, and also we have the new Predator, the Cleopatra. It looks kind of clean. We'll talk about this more in our first look video very, very soon. But we can't play the character this very moment, since the character's locked even after purchase. It's been happening on the Epic Games client to me every time there's a new DLC. Kind of annoying, but we'll get through it and we'll highlight our first look on this in the future. Guaranteed. So part of the free update is now there's fighting bots that are available in the hunt. So if you don't get any team members, you'll get bots to replace those team members in a fight in those actual games. So I'm guessing these get also deployed when people rage quit on your team. That could be a possibility. They do support roles, throwing ammo and health packs at you, revive down players, and players have the ability to take over fighting bots if killed. So it gives you a bit of option of what they can actually do. That's maybe majority of this update being the 8GB update that's happened on the Epic Games client. That is going towards these bots. Followed up by the new collectibles, the sniper rifle from Isabel being at level 100, and the actual Isabel tapes being unlocked at that aspect. Added Almond skins for level 100 and 150 for the Elder Predator, Jungle Hunter 87 and Alpha Predator, and some exclusive skins and tints for the Valkyrie Predator. They fixed some exploits on some of the maps, on headquarters and such, and now also giving the mercenaries some flashback grenades to actually utilize in their gameplay. Some issues with Clash being fixed as well. Okay, not too crazy there, and the fighting update has some aspects towards that, fixing some of the animations and issues that occurred there in big head mode and such. Nothing crazy. Honestly, that is the update. That is the 8GB update of patch notes 2.25 for Predator Hundergrounds, and that's just like a big shock to me that we got nothing else. And there's also another blog being the PlayStation blog, so maybe I'm like, they'll give us some more information there. They highlight the Predator, so I'm like, okay, cool. You can see the skin, the customization of what the character looks like. I'm like, that looks pretty clean. It's a nice aesthetic. It reminds me of some other characters that will make theme builds in the future. But this is crazy to actually see. I like the way it looks. It's kind of intriguing. But then the reskin weapon looks kind of cool too. But we need more weapons, so I feel like that's such a missed opportunity that the Smart Disc doesn't function in any way differently compared to just a reskin of what we already have from day one. So that's kind of annoying. And alongside that, they do mention that they have bots and they highlight the bots in game. So we get an image of that, what the bots could look like. Pretty much have names like Bot Bravo, Delta, and then also Charlie, and you're pretty much Alpha, but you're not a bot, so keep that in mind. So that's just been implemented in that factor there. And they also highlight the roadmap. What is the roadmap for the future? What is it? We don't know. It says October, there'll be another free update, and that's pretty much it. Because every update's every 2 months from now. The only thing they've highlighted as future aspects is that they've heard us, or heard our request for more Yautja and modes. And while we can't share any details yet, they said keep eye on the social medias and yada yada yada. You know what it is. Just essentially waiting for whatever's going to happen in the longevity of this game. And that's going to coincide alongside the September 7th free-to-play on PlayStation Plus memberships. When a lot of players start to come in, that's going to highlight if people actually are playing the game. Is this player base going to go higher? Most likely. And the new players stay on the game? That's another questionable thing. Will they enjoy it? Will they hate it? Will they stay for the long run? It depends. It all depends. And that may actually factor into the future DLCs if we get more or if we don't get any more. So I feel like there's going to be a cut down very, very soon on future aspects of DLCs and updates. That's what I feel like, due to his duration of the Predator Hundergrounds phase. I believe that may be the case there. Also, since we are now in-game, we can actually highlight what the character looks like. So let's go to our class types here. And we're able to go towards the Cleopatra Predator, which is locked. And I also purchased it. It still won't let me play it. So that's some weird bug that happens on the Epic Games client. And it gets quite annoying, but we'll fix it as we go. So the Cleopatra class attributes of health. Seems we maxed out. The stamina are a little bit reserved at nearly 1.5 bar, 1.6 even. Move speed is at 1 out of 4, and gear is a little bit higher at 2.25, around that. So there's nothing too crazy. These stats don't look that great on paper. Maybe changes in the actual gameplay, I'm not too sure. We'll find out as we go. While encounters with the Predator females have been rare, Predators of the Cleopatra's prowls are rarer still, as the only Predator to defeat Dutch in combat, she's also the only Predator known to spare an armed opponent. was a mercy or a threat. Perhaps it was just a professional courtesy from one hunter to another. Obviously, this character did fight Dutch, and that's the idea there of highlighting that actual components. The Ancient Disc. A sharp blade disc held in hand can be used for quick, effective melee attacks for thrown and pivot by the wrist computer. Impacts with prey while piloting deals massive damage, wielded by the Yautja known as Cleopatra. So that is the idea there. That is pretty much it with this update. And you have bots. That is pretty much it. Nothing else has come out of this update, which is a bit of a bummer. I don't think that's a great thing, but that is all we have a part of this update. The Predator character is going to be somewhat cool, and we maybe have some crazy customizations coming out for that in our first look for that character. But when it comes to the potential of like new weapon setups and new perk builds, it's going to be very low. It'll be very low on that aspect unless the specialization is really different and it has a new specialization tied into the class. We'll talk about that further and further once we actually go into our first look video. But mates, tell me your opinions and thoughts in the comment section down below. Are you hyped about this update? Do you like it? Do you think it's a bad update? Tell me your opinions and thoughts in the comment section down below. I need to know because this is very crucial. And I feel like the updates are getting less and less content every time. So I'm a bit worried on the longevity of this game. But tell me, mates, your opinions and thoughts in the comment section down below. And as always, mates, it is a pleasure to have you guys on the channel as we go through this. And I'll catch you, mates, next time. Bye. Road to 100k subscribers. Let's get it, mates.